Hey guys, my name is David, also known as Metal Haggis Cosplay. I do a range of cosplays, photography and filmmaking. I've been doing cosplay music video showcases for almost the past 3 years now, as well as other kinds of content on my channel. And
hello, I'm Jack, aka SuperJackTC on YouTube. I've been doing cosplay videos for just over a year now, and I've only started doing cosplay music videos for about 6 months. And yeah, that's me.
Hi, I'm Katie, I'm Kamikaze Katie on YouTube. I've been doing YouTube for 5 years, and I got into cosplay 2 years ago at Granite City Comic Con.
Or radio, no one really knows how to pronounce it. I started to make vlogs and videos kind of back in 2009, but I only really got into the cosplay scene kind of 2 years ago. So collectively we have 120,000 views on YouTube, so quite a lot of people watch us. The main reason we love YouTube is we're making videos for ourselves, for other people, to show them what we do at conventions. And we're all Scottish, so it's great. We're like a little community. So now we're going to talk about cosplay music videos. So I'll hand you over to you, Jack and David.
So how many of you do regularly watch cosplay music videos? Raise your hand. Has any of you watched me or Jack's music videos? So, the first stage of making cosplay music videos, when we plan out, the first thing we do is, of course, pick out our music. And when it comes to picking your songs, there's not really a wrong choice. If you can make it work, then it just works. Usually, we try and use songs from royalty-free music sites. When there's plenty, Epidemic Sound Player and Alpha Records, just to save using popular songs that will make YouTube angry with the copyright system.
Well, for me, I usually just shoot my footage first and then pick the music after. I just normally pick music that fits the tone or the feeling of the convention. And I do all this on my phone, pretty much. That's everything you need to make good YouTube videos, right here, palm of your hand.
So anyone can do it. It doesn't matter if you have like a camera or a phone, anyone can make a cosplay music video. When it comes to research, what I like to do, what me and Jack like to do, is make a Facebook event for whatever con or event that we're going to be filming at, and see what everyone's going to be cosplaying as to get a feel of what's going to be prepared ahead of time. And research, because say if some people will be cosplaying from The Walking Dead, I don't know, I don't watch The Walking Dead, so I don't know many of the characters. I only watch it one day. But I would look and see who people are cosplaying as and research. To help see what poses that they could do for the video on the day, which can help because some people might be nervous when I approach them to partake in the video.
I try to do my research as well, like what everyone's cosplaying, how that character would act in a music video type setting, I guess. And again, I pretty much just do the same thing as David does. Yeah, exactly. Like, we take inspiration from Sneaky Zebra and other sources as well. And me personally, I'm inspired by David here and Henry Wu as well. So, shout out to him.
Inspire each other, mate. So, when it comes to actual filming on the day on the con floor, the main part is what to film you're out there, because sometimes, no matter how much you plan what to film before the convention, the actual con itself will take you by surprise a lot. So just always be prepared, because you never know what kind of goofy antics you might be able to capture. A think a lot of people want to know is like how to approach people when you're making a cosplay music video, because when I first started doing it, I was very nervous about asking people. It is a nervous ordeal when you go up to people with a camera and you say, hey, would you like to take part in a cosplay music video at all? But it gets better with time, you gain more confidence. Just basically like a panel, I'm nervous talking to people in front of all of you, but you get better with time. Jack?
Yeah, very much the same for me. Going up and asking people for videos has gotten a lot easier over time. Definitely, like, a lot easier. Like, I'm trying to make my videos as good as possible, so I'm trying to get longer shots, longer videos, best possible angles I can get, so.
Of course, when filming at conventions, it's trying to find a space, because with some conventions it's really crowded. So what I've tried have a look around, see what area that is available. So you don't want to get other condors away when you're filming. So it's always best to look ahead of time to see if there's like nice areas you want to film in. They'll have a better background, because I don't like just telling people, excuse me, I'm filming a music video, could you please move out of the way? I don't do that.
Try again, wide open space for bigger groups, and even like any more than individual people.
Yeah. That's basically what we do when it comes to filming. But we love doing these music videos, because like even though it can be stressful, it takes a lot of work, both like planning it and editing it. But I love doing it because gives us such great memories to look back on, and I love making my friends look good in my cosplays, and the more you do it, the more better you get.
Yeah, I love doing it because I saw a lot of my friends doing it, and I thought I'd throw my hand in the ring and do YouTube videos. I did YouTube videos beforehand, and I thought, yeah, I'll just give this a bash, and it's something I've really loved doing for the past few months.
And that's basically it. That covers the cosplay news and video. We'll have some questions later. I've got questions that if anyone wants to answer, I'll pass it on.
We also forgot to mention at the start, if you have any questions and you don't fancy putting your hand up at the end, you can tweet us on hashtag RyconYouTube and we can see if we get any questions up. So while these guys kind of do the display, the cosplays that everyone does, we, me and Katie, tend to vlog the event. So rather than getting the costumes, we like to capture the actual event. Yeah. Depending on what kind of convention it could be, so like MCM lasts over 2 days, these ones are like 1 day, we'll prepare for what we're going to do each day. So usually we'll set 1 day aside for filming, and that day we'll wear a more comfortable cosplay that is easier to get around in. Like today, tend to not have big bulky props that can get in the way of us filming stuff. Or we tend to integrate our cosplays to fit the equipment we're using. So last year when I made my Leafeon cosplay, I made pouches to hold my SD cards in and batteries and other things to make it easier for myself. Any other tips you have? We're a friend. It's all, you know, we have each other. It's always good to film each other if you want some aesthetic shots of yourself in there, or just someone to hold your camera or your back. Made you do that quite a few times. So then, what do you aim to film, Katie?
Well, depending on what convention it is, there's different things going on. So there's panels that you might want to attend and film those. There's the con floor, of course, so we're showing like the shops and the different stalls and the artists. Definitely love doing some close-ups of those, because we're going to have a lot of similar shots today. We've just been to the same stalls all the day. Also the masquerade, we like to film that and get a general feel for all the different cosplays you might not have seen on the con floor, and individual cosplays as well. Just go up to people, and kind of like with cosplay music videos, we'll ask them, hey, can you be in our video? And sometimes it's a bit awkward, sometimes it's fine, but yeah.
I tend not to go up to people and ask to film them. If I want to kind of get videos of the cosplays, I tend to go along to the masquerade and try and get like a good view, just so I can get some videos of them. I tend to just do like around the event. And yeah, I've had a total blank. sometimes you can get quite a good few videos out of convention, so usually I'll do a kind of artsy video of the convention just to show it off in all its glory. But sometimes you can do the kind of blooper vlogs, which are more fun. That's a really bad angle of me.
So yeah, what we end up producing is like artsy vlogs. I just hit you, sorry. Also, I tend to do like a wrap-up vlog at the end, which tends to take 20 minutes or so of me just talking about all the things I did and what I enjoyed and who I met. Filming with other vloggers as well. So, like last year, we went to MCM, we stayed in Glasgow, so we made videos through the night and just documented the whole weekend, because the whole experience is the weekend, that is the convention for us. So that's another kind of video that we produce from conventions. So you got artsy, you got wrap up, and you've got fun. Oh, I didn't do fun. Do you want to do fun? You do funny ones.
Okay. I mean, you're always going to have kind of banter at conventions, so it's quite fun to just film it, and it's a good memory. Then you can make fun of yourself on the internet. People can laugh at you. So, talk about editing the vlogs. So, how do you edit?
Over the years, I've used different processes of editing because always different changing software. At the moment, I use my Mac and I have Final Cut Pro, and it's pretty simple. Just cut up my clips, use some filters, do different layouts and stuff. Usually try and sync it up with music, but that's more cosplay music videos out of things. I just like picking something that sounds kind of nice, and just, I don't think of it song too much. That's how I edit them. Do you have any other different process? No, we're just the same. I think we could talk about tutorials now.
Yeah?
So sometimes I like to film making my cosplay. Today I was making it in the car, so that just shows how prepared I was. Last year, however, I made an entire series as to how I made my Leaf Young cosplay. That is a nice awkward screenshot that Becca has decided to include of me in the process of making one of them. But I just did a series of how I went about making my cosplay. Because I'm filming it, I need to plan it. I need to make sure that it's going to make sense to people who are watching it. So structure is quite important, making sure I'm making the cosplay in order of how somebody else will probably make it, so that they're not going to end up with a half-made cosplay if the convention creeps up on them like it did for me today. So to achieve this, I'm making sure that I am planning it all and making sure all the shots are really clear. Another way of doing it is just making a wrap-up video at the end, which is probably what I'm going to do for this cosplay, because I didn't film this one, and explaining how I made it and showing clips. What do you do?
I think cosplay, putting my kind of cosplay tutorial in mind, it makes it really accessible to other people, so I'm a total newbie. I don't know how to do anything, so I really heavily rely on watching videos online. And I think especially if you've got a really kind of unique interest in cosplay, it's nice to film the creation so you might inspire someone else. And yeah, you can look back on it and see like how you made it and the techniques that you used and things. And as an art student, Katie will have a lot to say about that.
I actually love looking back on how much I've progressed. Like, maybe not so much with this cosplay, but definitely my first was Jinx. And honestly, I did nothing for it but makeup. And then I got to see me build something from scratch. I'm just like, oh, call me. So it's really rewarding for yourself as well as other people to watch back on. But yeah, as an art student, I should know how to do these things. So why we use YouTube for tutorials is because it's really accessible. You can share it anywhere and loads of people get to see it. And it's just a really good platform for people to come to and speak to you and say, oh, how did you do this? How did you do that? And you can tell them or show them. What else? Motivation? Do you
want to
go?
We're going to cover what motivates us to... No, wait, we just covered that. Yeah. But in general, what motivates us to make, you know, cosplay YouTube in general? David, do you want to go?
motivates me to do cosplay music videos is just because of the memories they create. The best feedback I can get from my music videos, and I've had this quite a lot, is whenever people that I know or some people that I don't know watch my videos and say and look back and say, oh, I remember this convention. I always have such good memories looking back whenever I watch your videos. And whenever I hear that, it just makes my day, because it's not only just like me just enjoying making a music video at the convention. It's people who I'm filming and enjoying watching themselves back and just having a great feeling and just themselves seeing themselves look so awesome. That's a great feeling.
Well, add to this Friday love of the convention, it's like cosplay and just spreading it all around and getting as many people involved as I can. Like my friend Sophie, this is her first convention actually. She's not even cosplaying, she's just coming because she wanted to come. So yeah, I just do this because I love to bring people together and I love to spread the experience that we all just love so much.
Okay. I think we're going to wrap up for questions soon. Nobody has used the hashtag, which is a little bit disappointing, but if there's any questions in the audience, do you want to like stand up? Oh, we got one over there in the orange. Come, Heather.
Just dispersed and gone their separate ways, probably to catch some Pokemon or cause some trouble.
Well, probably today there was a Ruby meet which I hosted, and there was like four different crows, like Uncle Crow and
Order of Crows.
I'd say that was more of a flock. And I meant to get a shot of them and I didn't. And I'm sad now. No, actually, there was five crows. Now that I think about it, so that makes it even worse.
Thank you for your question. Anybody else? Oh, I see two over there. Do you want to? When I was bored, and then I got to Comic-Con, and I realised that, hey, it's really fun to film this, so I just kind of got deeper, and yeah, that's where it went from there. What's inspired me is because I love just expressing myself in different mediums, film is something really interesting to me, and I think it's really rewarding seeing the process develop over 5 years. I'm just like, wow, my videos have gotten so much better! So you can start out on something really basic, like I was filming on my phone, you still film on your phone, but it's still really good, and like, it just goes up from there, so it doesn't matter what you start off with, because you know you're going to improve over that time.
I'm very much the same as Rebecca, but it's like, yeah, very much the same. I started a YouTube channel back in like 2009. I started with really, really terrible videos. Oh, they're so embarrassing. Don't watch them, please don't. But when I started doing cosplay videos about a year ago, filming at conventions, it just kind of took off, and my YouTube has grown so much since then. And yeah.
YouTube is a great platform for expressing your creativity. I've had my YouTube channel for many years now. Before I made cosplay music videos, I used to make kind of AMVs, anime music videos, but they're god awful, so like Jack said, don't watch them. I was inspired to make cosplay music videos by Sneaky Zebra and Blitz Visuals because I started doing them back at the second MCA in Scotland back in 2014, and no one was doing cosplay music videos for Scottish events. They were doing them for American cons and even some concert in London, but none for Scotland, so I thought, well, if no one else is going to do them up here, why don't I? I mean, they're very good, I might get better, but I'll give it a try.
Thank you. Is there any other questions? Oh, okay, there's loads of hands going up. Right, you're at the front there, so I saw you. I managed to hot glue gun my warbler thing to my body, which was pretty painful, and I was just sitting there on film like, don't do this at home, don't do this at home. This is the worst way to make a cosplay. Back, do you have anything pretty terrible?
Well, I think in terms of editing in general, just when you put everything on your computer and find that your clips are corrupted, or you're editing and you're like halfway through it, you haven't saved, and then your computer breaks, and it's just a disaster. It's traumatizing. Yeah.
I honestly don't know. And I'm not just saying that to save myself embarrassment. But if we're talking about embarrassing cosplay stories, I used to spray paint inside, like in my living room. Yeah, that looks good. Yep, fun times.
The most embarrassing thing that I ever happened to me when making a cosplay music video is back at Okinawa, and I can't remember who I was filming. It might have been Mr. Henry Wu. I was just as Jack Skelton, and I wasn't paying attention to my surroundings when I was filming them, and I fell backwards over a short brick wall and badly scraped my knee. So that's another thing I'm saying when making cosplay music videos, is always be aware of your surroundings, because you never want to bump into people and hurt yourself or themselves. It's the worst thing you can do.
We've got one more question. I don't want to pick Becca. Okay, girl with the white and black stroke. To watch, that's really hard. There's some really massive conventions out in like America, and there's Magro Serene. Has anyone heard of her? She makes amazing like videos of her experience, and I just love watching those because I'm like, I want to do that. It looks fun.
I really like watching the ones where people, like, they show you making the cosplay, but then they also kind of go behind the scenes and they show you their kind of like set up and their like cosplay room where they keep all their materials and stuff, because I'm skinny and I'm also not good at making things, so I like to dream.
As self-indulgent as it may sound, I like watching my own videos.
Nice plug. I love watching just like any cosplay music video that can bring a smile to face. I love watching the ones from American conventions like Cats and Con or Colossal Con, because I want to go to one of these conventions one day, mostly because they're sunny and they've got rainy weather like we've got for conventions over here.
Okay, thank you all so much for coming. There's so many people. I'm so happy that you turned out and there were so many good questions. If you still have a question, feel free to tweet it. One of us will reply because we're really happy you all came. And yeah, thank you so much. Anyone else?
Thank you everyone for staying this long.